A former Universal Champion has returned to WWE, and MJF is set to return to AEW Dynamite. But first, we have more details on the backstage fight between CM Punk and the Elite. Following this weekend's AEW All Out event, CM Punk would take to the post-show media scrum to address the wrestling media, giving his side of the story regarding recent reports that he was responsible for the AEW departure of his former friend Colt Cabana. He would then accuse AEW EVPs, the Young Bucks, and possibly Kenny Omega of leaking lies to the dirt sheets in order to sabotage the company's top babyface. Not only this, but he would call out Hangman Page for going into business for himself after he referred to the Colt Cabana situation in the build-up to their Double or Nothing world title match. On top of this, he referred to comments from Hangman during a Q&A, who dismissed the idea of learning from locker room veterans, calling him empty-headed. According to numerous sources, Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks would then confront Punk in his locker room after the media scrum, which led to a brawl. Punk is said to have taken a swing at Matt Jackson, this before Ace Steel threw a chair that knocked Nick Jackson out, before Ace then grabbed Kenny Omega by the hair before biting his face, this according to reports from Fightful Select and the Wrestling Observer. Whilst it's clear that all parties are in the wrong here, the main question that fans are wondering is, well, who started the fight itself? Brian Alvarez would take to Wrestling Observer Radio to discuss what he's heard on the matter, with his sources split on who was to blame, and Brian would say, "The disagreement between the two sides is that one side claims that CM Punk threw the punch first, the Young Bucks walked in and he started punching. The other side claims that the Young Bucks stormed in and were the aggressors and that Punk and Ace were defending themselves." Now, I normally try to stay relatively impartial, but here's how I see things and how I think this should be dealt with by Tony Khan. The AEW EVPs are completely in the wrong if they have been leaking information about Punk, especially in regard to Colt Cabana, something that was clearly a very emotionally distressing situation for all involved, with their friendship ending in such a bitter way. With stories that Punk feels are lies spreading like wildfire over recent weeks, tarnishing his reputation, I feel like he has every right to tell his side of the story. If the stories are true that the EVPs have been leaking information to tarnish Punk's reputation, they should be removed from their executive roles, remaining in the company as wrestlers. The goal of an executive is to ensure that the company makes as much money as possible, and that ain't it. Secondly, the EVPs should have waited until things cooled off before confronting Punk about it, but again, they were likely in an emotional state, so it's hard to blame them. Thirdly, Punk or anyone involved should not have gotten physical, and anybody that did get physical should be suspended, as we saw with Eddie Kingston. And lastly, if Ace Steel did what he is said to have done, that goes beyond throwing hands and he should probably leave AEW. With that said, he is in fact not expected to return to his duties in AEW, this according to Fightful Select. According to Dave Meltzer on Wrestling Observer Radio, legal actions are being considered, although it's not clear by which side, so we will likely see no comments from either side whilst this is being considered. Hopefully things don't get that far, and let's hope it can be settled with a handshake instead, but that's probably a little bit optimistic at this point. But what do you make of the whole situation, and how should Tony Khan deal with the Elite, CM Punk, and Ace Steel? Let me know in the comments down below. And next, Triple H has been promoted to a higher role in WWE. Following the retirement of Vince McMahon on July 22nd, Nick Khan and Stephanie McMahon were promoted to co-CEOs of WWE, whilst Paul Levesque, better known as Triple H, was promoted to head of creative. Well, Paul has once again received a promotion to an even higher role, following the impressive ratings that WWE television has seen since he took over the on-screen presentation. In a statement released by WWE, they would reveal that Triple H is now the chief content officer, with him now having more responsibilities, and they would say, "Since taking over creative for WWE, Levesque has architected a 15% spike in Monday Night Raw viewership and double-digit increases in social media engagement. As chief content officer, Levesque will oversee creative writing, talent relations, live events, talent development, and creative services. The role will report to WWE co-CEO Nick Khan." In the statement, Triple H would add some words of his own, and he would say, "WWE is one of the most prolific producers of premium content in the world, and I look forward to this amazing opportunity. Having spent my entire career in this business, I'm confident that we have the right pieces in place to continue to grow our audience and deliver for our fans around the world." The news follows the announcement of salary raises for Nick Khan, Triple H, and Stephanie McMahon, with the co-CEOs now earning $1.35 million per year, whilst Triple H brings in $900,000. Next up, CM Punk has detailed his recent recovery from injury. Just days after winning the AEW World title for the first time at Double or Nothing 2022, CM Punk would be ruled out of action due to injury, leading to an interim champion being crowned. Lost amongst the heated remarks from the recent post-All Out media scrum, Punk would discuss his recovery from foot injury, something that he struggled with mentally. Punk would confirm that the injury occurred when he did a stage dive during his entrance on the June 1st episode of Dynamite, right before the Trios match that saw him team up with FTR to take on Max Caster and the Gun Club, and he would say, "I did the stage dive, what an idiot. I must have hit my foot on the top of the guardrail, but I didn't feel it. You would think that would hurt, but people caught me, put me back down. I waited for FTR, it just didn't feel right. I thought I just whacked it. Blew a springboard, came off the top with a double axe, did all this shit. What I eventually did was, yeah, I fractured my foot, but then I pulverized the bone. Surgery was supposed to be an hour, it wound up being 4.5 hours. I got 3 plates and 16 screws in my foot, and I essentially have a new foot now." Of course, working the match only aggravated the problem, and in hindsight, his involvement should have probably been limited to just the finish. Punk would detail the struggles that he had during the recovery, crediting his wife AJ Lee for her support throughout the process, and he would add, "It is 100%, but it's a new 100%. Every day I rehab. This is the worst injury I've ever had. I was in the bedroom for 2 weeks, and it was really hard for me because I wanted to have this great summer, do good for Tony, sell tickets, draw money and ratings. The rehab, I could tell you how hard and painful and grueling it was, but I wouldn't be able to do it justice. I was doing 2.5 hours of rehab, plus once they told me I could bike, I was biking my life away. Then I would go to the gym later and lift weights. I was trying to bust my ass to hurry up. Not necessarily hurry up to get back, but hurry up and get healthy. If I'm not healthy, I'm no good to anybody. It was really tough. If I was 23, it would have been a hard injury because I literally couldn't do anything, trying to get around on crutches up and down stairs. It was pretty bad and depressing." Punk would eventually make his return on the August 10th episode of Dynamite, working 2 matches since, and since then, all hell has broken loose. And next up, a former Universal Champion has returned to WWE. Last night on Monday Night Raw, a fatal 4-way would be held to decide the next number one contenders for the undisputed WWE Tag Team Championships, with Los Lothario, Street Profits, New Day and Alpha Academy competing in the matchup. Proceedings would then be interrupted by Braun Strowman, making his first appearance since his WWE release back in June 2021. He would wipe out the field before throwing Angelo Dawkins through the barricade and Otis through the announce table. His return has been speculated on since last week when it was reported by PW Insider that he was scheduled to be at Raw last night. Braun would take to Twitter to address his return after the show, simply posting, "I've missed you all so very much. Hashtag thank you." He is now set to be at SmackDown this Friday after declaring that nobody is safe when asked for comment backstage. But what do you make of Triple H's latest rehiring? Let me know in the comments down below. And before we get into our final story, make sure you drop a like on the video and subscribe with notifications turned on, as it would really help me out. The channel's been doing great recently, at least in terms of people coming back and watching, but a big percent of you aren't yet subscribed. So yeah, if you do enjoy the videos, I'd really appreciate it. But with that said, let's crack on with the last news story of the day. And finally, MJF is set to return to AEW Dynamite. For those living under a rock, MJF would make his All Elite Wrestling return this past Sunday at All Out, winning the casino ladder match under a mask thanks to the help of Stokely Hathaway and crew, before confronting new AEW World Champion CM Punk at the end of the night. This was Max's first AEW appearance since his PIPEBOMB promo on June 2nd, which saw him air his grievances with AEW President Tony Khan, who has seemingly now given in to his financial demands, at least in storyline. Well, it has now been announced that MJF will officially be on AEW Dynamite this Wednesday on September 7th, 3 days after his much anticipated return. The show will go down in Buffalo, New York, which is of course the home state of the devil himself. With the promo now set for this Wednesday, it's not entirely clear what MJF will say, with him forever being unpredictable on the mic. However, there is a lot of things going on this week in AEW, particularly when it comes to his upcoming opponent CM Punk, with fans wondering how far he's willing to go with his words. It'll also be interesting to see what kind of reaction he receives, with it possible that the audience will be 100% behind him, with many feeling that he is the new voice of the AEW fanbase, with many agreeing with his June 1st promo when it comes to ex-WWE talent joining the company, overshadowing the likes of MJF. With there now being more real-life heat on Punk than ever, it may be time for Max to embrace the cheers and finally become the man of the people. Another factor is whether Punk will be able to appear on the show, or if the backstage fight that happened after fallout will lead to suspensions across the board. It's certainly going to be an interesting one, to say the least. But how far do you think MJF will go in his upcoming promo? Will he reference the ongoing CM Punk and the Elite situation, or will it remain off TV for now? Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And before you go, make sure you check out the 12 most obscure WWE appearances from AEW wrestlers.